Hi, Ross here from Search and Filter. Today I'm going to show you how to use Search and Filter version 3 with Beaver Builder. Let's get stuck in. So what we've got here is a relatively clean installation. We have the Beaver Builder plugin installed, Beaver Themer, which probably won't be necessary for today. We have Search and Filter and the Pro Beta. WooCommerce is also installed. And then we have the Search and Filter Beaver Builder extension. Make sure to get that from your account under the extension section, and then you can download it there. The first thing we're going to do is create a page in Beaver Builder, add a post module to it, and then we'll create our filters and our Search and Filter query and get that all working. And then after that, I'm going to do the same with WooCommerce. So let's start by creating a new page. And then in this page, we'll just make a two-column layout. We'll make this one 20%, and that one's at 80%. And on the right side, we'll add the post module. For now, we'll just leave those settings as they are. And then on the left side, we'll be adding search and filter fields. So what we need to do now is go to the admin section, create some search and filter fields, and then connect that to this post module with a query. So we can do that by heading to the search and filter dashboard. We'll start by doing the query integration, and that just tells search and filter how the fields and where the fields are connected to on the front end. So we'll start with the integration type is single. We'll dynamically detect the current page for the filtering. And then we'll choose the query from the query dropdown. And here we can use Beaver Builder posts. And then in the query settings, we'll leave it as posts. We'll leave the indexer off for now, but it's probably something you'll want to enable. And we'll have dynamic update on, and we won't bother with the loading icon for now. So let's save that. You can see the post query has been created in the query section. And now we can add some fields to the query. So we'll add a search field to start. Save that, head back to the query, and I guess we'll create categories and taxonomies fields, choice fields. So we'll choose the data type, taxonomy, make sure it's selected to categories. We'll update the label. And there's a ton of settings here, but we're not going to go into those. We'll save that one. Now we go back to the query. We have a search field, a categories field, so let's add a tag field. That's also a taxonomy. This one will make a checkbox. And we'll save that. Now that's saved, we'll head back to the query. And I think the last thing we need is a reset button. That's a control type field. We'll change the control type to reset, update the label, and save that one. So now we have our search and filter query. We have our connected fields. And now we want to go back to the editor and start building everything out. So I'll start by refreshing the page. So the new queries and filters show up. The first thing to do is in the post module, in the source section under the content tab, we'll change that to search and filter query. And then from the dropdown, we can choose posts, which is the one we just created. We'll save that. And then it's a little bit tight. And then in the left column, we'll add the fields that we just created. So these are search and filter fields. I'm just going to add several of them at the same time. I think it's four of them, so it's a bit faster. One, two, three, and number four. Okay. So let's change the first one, and then you'll see you get a drop down to choose one of your previously created fields. So I'll start with the search. That's updated there. And then I'll do the categories. And then the tags. Here we need a bit more room in this column. Okay. And then I'm just missing the reset button. Okay, so that's the basics done. Let's test that. Yeah, and you can see that's working straight away. Always nice. What you notice is the fields are quite static, so we'll go and update some settings now, make this a little bit more interactive, add the dynamic fields. So when we choose one of these options, these other options should filter down. So we can do that by enabling the indexer. And we'll save that. And we might have to wait a few seconds, or we can check. There we go, that's synced. You can see the options are now dynamic. And I'm not liking what's going on with the counts on these checkboxes. So let's put them like that. That looks a bit tidier. Okay, so that was quite easy, quite quick. We'll do the same thing now for the products module. So we've got WooCommerce set up here with the sample product. So we should be good to go. I'll start by creating a new page. We edit that with Beaver Builder. And We'll do a two column row again. Yeah, let's make it wide this time. And this column will make 20%. Now we can add our WooCommerce module. And we need to choose specifically multiple products. And then from here, we see we have the search and filter options again. We don't have a query yet though, so I'm just going to leave it as that. So we have our layout done. Let's go back into the admin and let's create our search and filter query and the search and filter fields that will be attached. So this is a product, same setting as before, dynamic current post. This time we'll choose the Beaver Builder WooCommerce products query. We'll see the post types as being automatically set to products. We'll enable the indexer. And make sure our dynamic update is on. Let's save that. And now let's add some product filter fields. So we could do an autocomplete to start. And we could do that one on, well, we can choose the data type WooCommerce, and then we can choose WooCommerce categories. So we can do an autocomplete field to start as a search type field. We'll choose for the data type WooCommerce this time, and then we'll choose the categories. And the input type will be autocomplete. And we'll leave the rest as it is, save that. Let's add a product attribute. We can do attribute size. We can make that a checkbox. And save that. Then let's also add an on sale checkbox. And we'll save that one. And then, same as before, let's add a reset button. Which is the control field. And that's that one done. So now we've got our query set up and we've got our fields added. We can go back to the Beaver Builder editor and connect everything up. So we'll start with the products module. We'll change the product source to search and filter. And we'll choose the products from the dropdown, the products query. We can save that. And in the left column, we want to add our fields. So we can start with the autocomplete field. And then we'll add the size field. And then the on sale checkbox. And then finally, the reset field. And if we check that, hopefully everything will be working together nicely. Yeah. We've seen very quickly how to use Search and Filter version 3 with Beaver Builder. We've created one demo using the post module, another demo using the products module. I'd love to get your feedback if you come across any issues at all. You can leave a comment below or get in touch via the usual channels. Thanks for watching.